So, we've added, okay, we can join matches, we can create rooms and stuff like that. Now let's pass the items. Before we do that then, we're going to load the scene and we're going to clean this up slightly and get the references, drop it on here, and I want game manager canvas. Actually, I'm going to take the event system, drop it underneath my game manager. For now, let's not worry about the enemy manager, so delete that. And I want to get both my game manager and the canvas and drag it and drop it right on to the Lancer. We now have two canvases and two event systems, so I'm going to delete the first event system and I'm going to get this canvas and I'm going to take everything and drop it under the canvas where we have our game stuff. Delete that. Let's create an empty one more and say multiplayer anyway. Get all that, drop it down here. I'm going to bring the panel right on top, and I also want to create one more, which I'm going to say loading. It's still a panel. Let's delete these backgrounds. Let's add a text. Drop it underneath the loading. Change this to something yellow. Increase the size. Okay, and just say loading. Let's disable this for now, we don't need this at this moment. Okay, and we have all this. And let's go and write a new script. Let's add it on the utilities, and it's just going to be a don't destroy. Open this up. Okay, delete this, add the namespace. And the only thing I want to be doing over here is basically say don't destroy on load and just add this game object. So where we add this, when we're changing scenes, it's not going to destroy these game objects, so we can have persistence along our scenes. Now, I actually want to get the scene manager as well and drop it underneath the game manager, because all of these are child objects. If I add on the game manager don't destroy over here, I'm going to keep all my objects. Okay, I want to do the same for my canvas as well. Save, and we have a camera over here. Let's drop this as well inside the game manager, and I want to go and say on this camera, instead of solid color, just do don't clear, so you don't render anything. Okay, save that, and let's rename the scene. The reference scene, we don't need it anymore, so we can just go and delete it. It's empty. And the menu, let's rename this to main, and it's basically going to be a scene where we're going to be dropping the objects that get instantiated over the network. Remove that. Let's also go to the build settings. Let's go to the main. Let's delete the reference and the main. And I'm going to drag again and drop the main. Okay, save. Now, there's a few things we need to change. Let's go into the scripts, onto the Lancer. We don't have any more menu, so let's rename that to main. And I want to go into my actual controller on the input handler and everything we have on our start. I want to change this and do a public void init. Let's just take all of that, cut it and paste this in here. We won't need the start anymore, but let's keep it. But what I would do want to change is I'm going to add bool is init end. Let's go into the fixed update and say if not is init, just return. Same in the update, if not is init, return. Now, the way we instantiate the objects when we're loading the scene, basically, this is going to give us a few errors right now. So what I want to do, at least for now, is I'm going to do another coroutine and say init local, and let's just do a yield return new, wait for seconds, just do 0.1 and cut all of this and paste this down here. Okay, and inside over here, let's say is init will be true. So if you are this guy, if you are local, just do init local. So you just have a small delay when you initialize. Otherwise, it's a dummy object, so just init right now. Okay, and you will see where this is going to come into play. So let's say we want to pass data over our, when we instantiate our characters, we want to pass some data. So we actually, that data is our, well, you know, is our items and the equipment and stuff like that. So going on to decision manager, let's pin him also. Let's also pin the state manager over here. Okay, so on to decision manager, we have our instance or our instantiate from Photon, which we do over here. We have this object field, which it means we can pass objects and it will pass them along with a controller. And we can say object or better yet, object, objects, a new array of objects, and let's see how much we want to pass. We're going to be passing the strings and not the integers. The integers reflect into item instances. Okay, we don't care about the item instances, we only care about the actual strings. That will be these four, and for now, at least, let's do only this, only the you know, the weapons, and on a later one we're going to see. So we have six objects, it's this, and that will be that object. The first object is going to be the chest piece. It's going to be the a hands piece. This needs to be an array, of course, and objects a head piece, objects a leg piece. Okay, now the weapons, because they are in a list, we kind of need to do things slightly different. And in that case, we're going to check if equipment right hand dot count is greater than zero, then just assign the first one, you can actually just assign everything. But for right now, let's just say assign the first one. Otherwise, just assign an empty string. Then EQ left hand, count is greater than zero, objects 5 this time, equals EQ left hand, weapons 0, okay, and then else objects 5 like this. Okay, and just pass the objects down here. Save, and then on the state manager there is a new call we can use that comes from Photon, and it's called void on Photon instantiate, and it takes a Photon message info. We have the array of objects, we have the objects themselves, and we now have photonView.instantiationData. Okay, so this will run every time we actually instantiate something. Now, the only problem we're going to face in here is that we are passing strings, but our inventory manager and our armor manager in extent is using integers, and that has to do with you know, the fact that we're using item instances and stuff like that. But for a dummy controller, we don't need to have item instances, we just want them to know that, you know, that object is visible, that mesh we're using, just use that. And that's really easy to fix. Let's go open our armor manager, and over here we have this, so we can just say public string multiplayer chest ID string, let's make this capital, legs ID m head ID, and public string m hands ID. Back to the state manager. So we are over here. We have to manually get the armor manager because it doesn't has yet initialized, and we have our armor manager. So we're going to say armor manager dot m chest ID, for example, and it's going to be objects. Let's make a new vertical tab group so we can see the order we are passing them. You can see that the first one is the chest piece. So if we pass 0, but we need to know what this is, so we're going to cast this as a string. Okay, so we pass, we cast it as a string, and it means this is going to be the chest ID you're using. Next, we have the hands string objects 1 head ID string, oops, that's the M hands, that's the M head ID, objects 2, and then arm M hands head ID legs ID string objects 3. Okay, let's make sure we are correct. Hands ID, head ID, and then of course the legs ID. Now this passes this over here. And I believe That's pretty much what we need to do. But because we have changed the, let's bring this back in this tab, let's pin it as well. And because we have removed on the input handler, we have removed the initialization, we need to do this manually now. And again, that's easy to do. Let's cast the input handler input. Let's do a get component input handler. Let's just say input dot init. Okay, save and let's see. Have this. Now, we have removed a few things. For example, when we initialize right now over here, as you can see, when we init, if he's local, only then we initialize the inventory manager. We don't want that. We're going to cut this and initialize anyway. Okay, even if we are local or not, we still want the inventory manager. But we're still going to go inside here, inside this, and we're going to clear a few things. For example, we don't want this anymore if we're not local, because as you can see, this gets the values from the season manager. Okay, that's not what we want to use. So I'm going to say if states.isLocal is false, so it's not a local, simply return. Or actually, instead of putting this over here, because we do add a few empties, we're going to do this down here. Okay, this will stay the same. Load inventory, I believe, is going to be, for the most part, we're going to need this. Okay, and then we need to also change the armor manager. For the armor manager, I'm going to be passing the states as well. And let's go to definition. And I'm going to add a reference to the state manager. And store them in here as well. ST equals, states equals ST. So you have equipped all. But if states is local, only then equipped all. Otherwise, we want to do void equip all multiplayer. And let's maybe take this a little bit further down, like here. Let's do an else. That's not an else. And similar to what we have over here, load armor, we're going to be doing load armor multiplayer, void load armor multiplayer. And we only want to be passing a string ID, and let's also pass the armor type, although it's going to be used for when we are not we don't have something. So what we need to be doing over here, we first need to check if string dot ID equals to the empty, or is just empty, is null or empty. And if that's the case, just say unequip armor, close that. Okay, so this will take care of if we are not wearing something over there. Otherwise, create an armor container and go to your resources manager. resources manager, get armor. It's just going to bring us back the entire container from the ID. Okay, and then just simply saying equip armor, arm, and load armor multiplayer. The first one is going to be, well, we basically need this chest ID, armor type, chest. Copy that, paste this 3 times, and let's make the other one hands, legs, and head. Chest ID. Head ID. Hands ID. And legs ID. Oops. Yeah, this will be head. This will be hands. And this will be legs. Okay, so basically it just cuts this, because when we are not online, we are searching for item instances, because we might have multiple multiple item instances. Even if they are the same thing, we might be using a different item. Okay, so on multiplayer we don't care about an item instance, we just want, it's just visual. So we, you know, skip this part and just go directly into getting the armor container. Okay. Okay, let's see. What else do we need? Season manager, controller, and save everything. Let's go now and get to the UI manager. Let's see what the error is. On the armor manager, we need to be passing also a state when we want to load the inventory, and just passing states over here should fix that. Okay, clear. Let's fix the canvas a little bit, because we have all this stuff. So let's go to the UI manager, if we can find it. UI manager, and let's add a few more things. We have game UI, main menu. Let's add game object, loading. Let's add the backward panel, back panel, and of course game object, multiplayer. Okay. So on the input handler now, we just need to know when we want to close the stuff we have on the UI. So maybe on the UI manager, let's pin him as well. Let's create a public function over here. Let's say public void open game UI, and we're going to be saying main menu set active false, loading set active false, back panel set active false, multiplayer set active false, and then game UI set active true. Let's see how much we have. I think we might need to add one more. Main menu, loading, oh, back panel. This is 5, okay. Back to the input handler over here, then we can just say UI manager, UI manager, open game UI. Okay, so on the season manager then, we can, not on the season manager, I think we want the Lancer. Lancer. we should be creating, for example, let's see, we have our start update. Well, we're joining a room, for instance. We can add a new call over here, public override void on join room, and just say UI manager singleton and say multiplayer set active false and UI manager singleton not multiplayer main menu, which is basically the start game button we have. Turn this to true. Let's check if we have anything else. And on connecting to master now, we already have that. Join lobby on connected to master. We are doing this, but we can also do. No, actually, this would be enough, I believe. But over here, we can just enable the main menu, UI manager, when we load the level, UI manager, singleton, main menu, set active to true. Okay, let's test this now. Let's go into our UI manager and we have, wait till it's load. We need the loading, drop it down here. We have the back panel and we also want the multiplayer. Save, hit play. And it's just going to say that the scene references. Yeah, we need to also remove the scene references from the My Scene Manager. So basically, it's over, it should be. This one. Okay, we don't want this anymore. No need to load the scene references. It doesn't have anything. We just encapsulated everything into the Lancer scene. Hit play. On hit play, we should disable the main menu on start. Start, so let's say UI manager, singleton, main menu, set active false. Okay, connecting, join lobby, create room, creating a room, start game. Let's see what we have forget. We have forgot to assign on the scene manager the menu camera. And this is just for, you know, we're not getting spammed with the error we have over there. With a warning, not an error. Start game. Everything plays normally and we are in. Okay, so let's do a build. And I'm going to pause till it's done. And we're back. Open the build. Okay. Play. This guy is going to play normally. Create room. Creating a room. Start game. Did I click this? No, I clicked it. Okay, and we're in. I think the. Yeah, maybe we have a few more issues with our UI. We're going to fix them as on a second phase. No need to complicate things. Leave this guy on the side, and I'm going to go into my game manager, and I'm just going to delete the Viking chest from the chest piece. Okay, hit play. Connecting to server, we have the available rooms, join. And we forgot to open the canvas, or to close the canvas, actually. So let's say on the controller, If we go into the scene, into the actual scene, let's close the canvas so we can see where this instantiate controller is. Okay, this guy is normally, he has the items he's supposed to has to have. Oops. Let's say assets, not assets, let's add a light. Okay, you can see he's wearing the items we have on the side. And if I move on the other way, it plays as well without any issues. Okay, now, and actually, yeah, let's try this again because I want to show you that it's actually working. Joining. If I close the multiplayer and just open the loading, not the loading, the main menu, and click start game, we are in, and not only we are in, we do wear a different item. Of course, we're not passing the swords and stuff like that yet. We'll do that on the second phase. So that means we have different, we can pass different outfits. Close that. And let's add on the Lancer. Don't destroy. So it's not that we forgot to close our canvas. We forgot to add the don't destroy. If we destroy the Lancer we have over here, then the on join lobby, not on join lobby, on join room will never run, obviously. Okay, join room, joining room, we are in, start game, and we are back again, and everyone is wearing different stuff. Okay, let's test this a bit more. Game manager, let's go naked. Join room, joining, start game, and we're now naked. Same from the other way, from the other side. Okay. Awesome. So it's just a matter of passing the correct data right now. Let's see. We should check how we, what we are doing with the weapons. So let's go and change, we don't need this build anymore, close this. Let's go into our inventory manager. And we can just bypass all of this and only pass the weapon we are using. So let's say public string, let's only do the one hand, right hand weapon, and we'll see. So on the state manager, on Phonton instantiate, let's do inventory manager, inventory, get component, inventory manager, all of that, inventory dot M, right hand weapon, string, objects, for save, and let's go again into the inventory manager. And here, let's pin this, and let's go into the init. Load list, clear references, load inventory. We still need this. Okay, unarmed, consumable items, and then for each right hand weapon you have, if it's minus one, then you are loading the unarmed runtime. Otherwise, you're still looking for the inventory instance, and then using the same ID, and I think this needs to pass a string. Okay, so it means we basically need to override this. Okay, so let's do this then. We're going to say if states dot is local. Do all of this. Otherwise, if right hand weapon equal, or let's do this cleaner, string dot equals m right hand weapon to either unarmed or m right hand string dot is null or empty, m right hand weapon. Then do this, else random weapon, and just pass the m right hand weapon. Oh no, we need all of this. Random weapon, get weapon, m right hand weapon, and close that. Okay, and it's just going to add the, it's going to add this over here, and I believe this will just continue and play normally. Save, and this might give us an error. So let's say update actions only if states.isLocal. No need to do anything if you are not local. Okay, save. Let's do another build. Replace it. We're going to try first with the right hand, and then we're going to worry about the left hand. Unless we forgot to do something else, anything else. Okay. Let's see where we're using this as well. Okay. So let's try the build. I'm going to leave this on the side. We don't have to join from this. We can just take look it from the inspector. Start game. I am playing. And maybe we have an error. Let's close this and let's see if this is going to play normally. Create room. Okay. What? Oh. Yeah, we have also level manager, we forgot to get something else, I believe. Let's see, scene manager, no. We also have the level manager. Let's take the level manager for now and just drop it underneath the game manager, which means let's also get the spawn position as well, so that it's on the same scene. This is not what we want to do in the final form, but for now it will work. Close that. No need to have paused. Come on, connect to server, create room, start game. Okay, and we are playing. Let's do the build then again. Let's open it up. We are in. Connecting to server. Find the room. No need to go inside the game. We can see from here that you actually have the weapon. Like this is the instantiated character. Okay. So, okay, we're over here. Let's click start game. Then, and we're in. Okay, so for the right hand it works. That means if we go and change this now for the left hand, hopefully it's going to play for that as well. So, copy this, add over here if states.isLocal. Do all of that. Otherwise, do this, but let's change the public string left hand weapon. And for left hand weapon, let's change this is local. Left hand weapon unarmed, left hand weapon, and over here left hand weapon, and this will be runtime left hand weapon, runtime left hand weapon. Okay, so let's test this one thing, and on the next one we're going to fix the bugs we have on the UI. And also make it so when you're actually changing items, it passes through the network. Let's open a build. Create room. Start game. Okay, we're in. Play. Actually, before we hit play, let's change our, let's say, Viking chest, leg piece, samurai legs, and we can even change the, from the great sword, let's change it to something else. Let's just change this to sword. Hit play. Join, then start game, and you can see we have our two swords, although I think, yeah, I think we missed something. Oh, we didn't miss something, we forgot to assign on the season manager, on this, not on this, on the state manager. We need to just do also environment left hand weapon string objects 5. Let's bring back the greatsword. Greatsword. Save. Let's do a build once more. We're back. Let's open. Okay, we are here. Then let's go on the game manager, change this to just sword. Let's remove the chest. Let's just say samurai head or helmet. I forgot what it is. Let's make sure it's the correct one. Armor items, samurai helmet. Save, okay, minimize, hit play. Join. Start the game. And here we are, although. Yeah, I guess we forgot a few more things then. And I'm going to guess it's going to be on the left hand weapon. On the inventor manager. Let's see. Left hand weapon, left hand weapon. Is this local? Interesting. Oh. Yeah, this actually needs to be above, outside of this. Let's see. So this will be if states dot is local. Do that. Otherwise, the for loops will end here, and the else should be down here. I think we have one more. This one's here and here. Can remove this and this. No. Else, this else, we should delete this. Okay, there's just no, there's no I in here, so this will be 0 and this will be 0 again. So the same things will happen in here. State is local. Okay, because if there wasn't anything on the left hand weapon in this array, then that means this will never run. But that's not the case if we are in multiplayer. Okay, let's try this and see if it plays locally first. Delete that. Hit play. Okay, it does. Then let's try the multiplayer. Do another build. We'll be back. Let's try. And now we still have the same issue, which is weird. So let's do let's go on the state manager, let's do a debug log string objects 5. Let's see what that's going to instantiate. This passes. Let's have a weapon. So this is correct list. So that means we've missed something else. Inventor manager then. What is this? This is the right hand weapon. Okay. This is the left hand weapon. Left hand weapon. Left hand weapon. Right. This is local. Let's do a debug log as well in here. And the state manager, let's delete this one. So that's correct as well. Let's see, inventory manager. Well, something is missing also. Normal ID. Oh, no, it doesn't miss. It's just over here. It just removes the M for some reason. I don't believe this will be the case, but let's be sure. Okay. W. So no, this runs correct, but this has the issue, which makes zero sense. Of course, let's see, equipped inventory, equip weapon, right hand weapon, equip left hand weapon. Oh. Yeah, I think this is probably one of the issues we have. The item Get item, no. Well, anyway, let's just leave this over here because I believe we might have screwed some things. And then turn this into an arrow, then this adds the index. No, this would have been correct. Let's try one more thing, I guess. Let's try and add a debug log over here. Let's check our lists. RL weapons, random spells, okay. Left hand indexes. This is local. Okay. And equip vector. And we burn FK indexes. Let's add the debug and say debug log w dot. Instance dot ID. Let's see what that's going to give us. And that is correct, yeah, so I guess. Well, anyway, this probably is something we missed. So I'm going to do this off camera, and then on the next video we'll see what the error was. So, till then, feel free to play around. We're still working, we still have a few bugs, of course, we're going to fix on the next video. Till then, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and if you like to support me so that I can keep making all this stuff, then you know how to do it, either via Patreon or via Gumroad. And I'm going to do the gesture via multiplayer. So, I'll see you next time.